Hi viewers, welcome back to my channel. So in this video I'm going to explain about the topic is statistics of class 10 math. And statistics, already you have come to know about the ungrouped data in your class 9. So class 10 deals with mainly grouped data. Anyway, I'll explain both ungrouped data and grouped data. First I'll go with ungrouped data, then after the next video I'll upload group of data. So first of all, what do you mean by statistics? Statistics is a branch of mathematics. Yes, it is a branch of mathematics dealing with data collection, organization, analysis, interpretation and presentation. So presentation in different formats like pie chart, tabular form, bar graphs, histograms, frequency distribution tables, these all we come to know in the class 9 itself. So this is about the statistics. So statistics is divided into two forms: grouped data, ungrouped data and grouped data. Ungrouped data, what do you mean by ungrouped data? Ungrouped data is nothing but collection of individual observations. So collection of individual observations, but not sorted in any groups or classes. That means these are not arranged or organized. So that is ungrouped data. Coming to the grouped data, collection of individual observations or data sorted into groups or tabulated. So that these are arranged, sorted into groups. That means in the tabular form. This is about grouped data. Anyway, ungrouped data and grouped data, both we have mean, median and mode. Mean, median and mode. In both the formats we have these three measures of central tendencies. We say these are the measures of the central tendency. Okay. So ungrouped data, we have first mean, median, mode, and after this one relation of three all. That means the central tendencies relations we have, that means the empirical relationship we say. And in this one grouped data, mean, median, mode, all three as of same in ungrouped data. Fourth one is ogive curves. We say ogive curves, this is nothing but the graphical representation. So four types we have in grouped data. That means tenth class syllabus mainly deals with all these four. Okay. In the mean, we have three types: direct mean, assumed mean, step deviation. All three comes under mean itself, but three different types to measure the mean value. Okay. So first I will explain now ungrouped data. So what do you mean by mean? First of all, mean is nothing but I say average value. So how to measure this one means the ratio of sum of the values of all observations to the total number of observations. So ratio of sum of values of all observations to the total number of observations. See, suppose if x1, x2, x3, so on, xn, that means n observations are there, are the observations for n observations, then mean is given by mean. Ratio of sum, he said, sum means plus. So sum of all observations, observations are x1, x2, x3. So x1 plus x2 plus x3, so on, plus xn up to n observations by total number of observations. How many observations are there means n, that is by n. So this formula is given by sum of all observations by total number of observations. Okay, I hope you understood the definition. We'll go to through some example. Yeah, so now examples of mean on ungrouped data. Question is, find the mean of first five odd numbers. What are the first five odd numbers? We'll write first five odd numbers. One, three, five, seven, nine, one, two, three, four, five, five are enough. Okay, what do you mean by mean now? Mean equal to, we got sum of observations by total number of observations. Sum of all observations sum of all observations. By total number of observations formula. Sum, so we will add it, 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9. By total how many observations are there? 5, so by 5. Add it, 4 plus 5, 9. 9 plus 9, 18. 18 plus 7. 25 by 5, 5 ones, 5 fives. So mean of the question is 5. Mean of the first 5 odd numbers is 5 now, answer. I hope you understood. We'll go to the second example. The mean of the observations 18, 14, 15, 19, 15A, 12, 15, 16 is 16. That means this is the second type to find out the missing frequencies. The observations he given in this type of question, he'll give the mean value. We should find out the missing frequency value. So we go through the formula, mean equal to, we'll add it all. He given this answer as 16. So sum of the observations 18 plus 14 plus 15, add them all, 19 plus 15. Plus A, write it as same, plus 12, plus 15, plus 16. Whole divided by, how many observations are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So totally 9 observations are there, by 9. This answer is given as 16. Add them all. So I'll go with the 15, 15, 15, 15. 3, 15, 15, 3 is 45. Plus 14 and 16, 14 plus 16 is 30, plus 18 plus 12 is 30, and 30 again, plus left is 19, plus A, equal to 9, bring this side, 16 into 9, cross multiplication, then add them all, 45, 30 plus 30 is 60, 60 plus 45 is 105, plus 19, plus A, equal to 16 into 9 is 144. So this value is 124. 105 plus 19 is 124 plus A equal to 144. Bring 124 this side, then A equal to 144 minus 124. That is nothing but 20. So in this way we should find out the missing frequency values if he mentioned the mean value. Okay. Now coming to the second central tendency measure, median. So median, it is a measure of central tendency which gives the value of the middlemost observation in the data. That means after arranging them in ascending order. So after arranging the observations of the data in the ascending order, we will pick the central value, that is the middlemost observation. So sometimes the observations may be even. Sometimes it may be odd. Odd means we can pick it up easily, but if it is even means we can't get the middlemost value. That means the value lies between two observations. So for that we have some formulas, then we will find out. So this is the mean definition, measure of the central tendency, the middlemost frequency observation. So for the n observations, if there are n observations, if n is odd, that means the total number of observations is odd number. Suppose 7 observations are there, like 5 observations are there, that means odd number. The median is given by n plus 1 by 2 observation. That means the observation value is n plus 1 by 2 observation. If it is even, total it is 4, 8, 10, like that number of observations. Then the median is average of n by 2 observation and n by 2 plus 1 observation. So between these two values, the value lies. So we will take average of these two values. Both the methods I will explain now. First example, find the median of first 7 composite numbers. So first 7 composite numbers is asking, 7 means odd. Anyway, first we will write composite numbers. What are the composite numbers? Four. That means composite number means nothing but not of prime numbers. If they have the multiples factors, so 4 then go with 6. 5 is a prime number. 6 after 7 is a prime number. Then 8, 9, 10, 11 is prime number. 12, 13 is prime number again. Then we go with 14. So these are the first 7 composite numbers. Okay. So how many we have? 7. So 7 is odd. What will be the median value? What is the formula? N plus 1 by 2. That means 7 plus, this is 7 plus 1 by 2 observation. 7 plus 1 is 8. So 8 by 2 is nothing but 4. So 4th observation is our median value. What is the 4th observation? This is arranged in ascending order anyway. Ascending order. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4th observation is 9. Answer median of the composite numbers, first 7 composite numbers is 9. Now coming to the second one. Find the median of first 10 prime numbers. So 10 means even. So second type I am explaining. Prime numbers. First 10 is giving means anyway they will arrange in the ascending order itself. So prime numbers will write 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, how many? Then 23, 29. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 prime numbers we have. So 10 means even. So even means what is the formula? N by average of median equal to average we should take. Average of 10 by 2 and 10 by 2 plus 1 observations. That means this is 5. This is 5 plus 1 is 6. So 5th and 6th average we should take. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is 11 and 13. 6 is 13. So 11 plus 13 by 2. 24 by 2, which is nothing but 12. 2 ones, 2 12s. So median for this question is 12. This is of even type. This is odd type. Okay. Next. Now, missing frequency values. How to find if the median value is given? In this question, if the median of the observations minus 2, 0, 3, x, 5, 7, 12, 17 is 4.5. These are arranged in the ascending order. What is the value of x? We should find out. That means the missing frequency here. So how many observations? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 observations are there. So n equal to 8, which is nothing but even. So what will be the median value? 8 by 2 and 8 by 2 plus 1 average. 2 fourths, here it is 4 plus 1, 5. So 4th and 5th observation average. 1, 2, 3, 4 is x and here it is 5. So x plus 5, average means 2 numbers by 2 equal to median value given as 4.5. Bring to this side, x plus 5 equal to 2 into 4.5. So x plus 5 equal to 2 into 4.5 is nothing but 9. That implies x equal to, bring 5 this side, 9 minus 5, which gives 4. So median value is 4. 3, this one value will be 4, then 5. So in this way, we should find out the missing frequency values. I hope you understood all types of median. Then I'll go for the mode. What is mode? A mode is that value among the observations which occurs most frequently. That means repeated. A mode is that value among the observations which occurs most frequently. That is nothing but mode. So simply we can see the repeated value, repeated observations, and we can write that observation as mode. So in these type methods, first example, find the mode of 23, 7, 13, 3, 4, 6, 7, 19, 15, 7, 18, and 3. So these are the observations. What are the observations? 23, 7, 13, 3, 4, 6, 7, 19, 15, 7, 18, and 3. So first we'll check mod equal to 3 repeated, 1, 2, 3 times 3 is repeated. Check with 7, 1, 2, 3 is repeated, 3 times 7 is also repeated. Then any number? No. So these two numbers are repeated. Suppose if I take one more 7 in this one, one more 7 observation, so totally it will be 4 sevens. It means 7 is repeated 4 times, 3 is repeated 3 times. Which one is greater means 7? So mod equal to 7, how many times it is repeated is, we should write that one, repeated 4 times. 3 is repeated 3 times, so we will not consider 3 value, 7 is the mod. So in this way, if the values are repeated in equal times of all the observations, see. Second example, find the mode of 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 4, 5, 5, 5, 6, 6, 6. So all are repeated 3 times. So how to take the mode value, what will be the mode value for this type of question means, whatever the number of observations repeated, that we will write 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All the values are mode. Why? Because all are repeating equal times. How many times those are? For this question, so repeated 3 times. So no need to confuse what will be the mode value. If observations are repeated in equal times, then we can consider those observations equally. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all are repeated 3 times. So all I am writing as mode. Okay, now the empirical relationship left from the ungrouped data. So there is an empirical relation between the three measures of central tendency. What is that measurements relationship? 3 median equal to mode plus 2 times of mean. 3 times of median equal to mode plus 2 times of mean. This is the empirical relationship. So for this type of relationship, the question, in the question he will give any of these three, he will give two values. He will be asking for the third value that we should find out. The question is, find the median of the data using an empirical relation when it is given that mode equal to 12.3 and mean equal to 10.5. So we will find out this value. We have the relation 3 median equal to mode plus 2 mean. We'll substitute this value in this one. Is asking for median, so write it as same, 3 median equal to, what is the mode value? 12.3, mean is 10.5, which gives 12.3 plus 10.5, 8, 2, 2, 22.8, 3 median equal to 22.8. Then median equal to, sorry, here mean value is 2, so 2 times of 10.5, that is 12.3 plus 21, 12.3 plus 21, 12.3 is the mode value, plus 10.5 into 2 is 21.0, that is 21 I am taking. So 21 plus 12.3 gives 3 here, 3 and 3, 33.3 value. So 33.3 by 3, which gives 11.1. So median equal to 11.1 is the value, median. So don't get confused that if the median, in this question median is asking, that is in the LHS, simply to add the RHS value, we'll get that one. So nothing to worry. I'll take one more example. Asking to find median, asking to find mean if median is given. Okay, now I'm taking one more example. in the previous problem he has asking median, but in this question he given median asking to find the mean value. So if for a certain frequency distribution median equal to 156, mode equal to 180, find the value of mean. So we'll take the same relation, 3 median equal to mode plus 2 mean. Same relation I'm taking, 3 into what is the median value we have, 156. So 3 into 156 equal to mode what he given as 180, write it as 180, plus 2 into mean, write it as same, 2 into mean. So 3 into 156, 156 into 3, 18, 16, 4, we get 468. So 468 equal to 180 plus 2 mean. Then 2 mean equal to, bring 180 this side, then we'll subtract 468 minus 180. So 468 minus 180, how much would we subtract? 468 minus 180, so here 8, 1 carry, 16 minus 8 is 8. So here 3, 3 minus 1 is 2. So you get 288. So 2 mean equal to 288. Then mean equal to 2 comes down divided 288 by 2. So 2 ones 2 1 4 4. So finally what we got, mean equal to 144. So in this way we need to find out. So for the same relation we can find out mode also. Okay, I hope you understood this video. So like the video, share, and please do subscribe. Thank you.